My name is Jessica Kennedy. I'm a certified personal trainer, a group fitness instructor, and a certified life coach. And what we are doing today is a dumbbell workout. So you need at least one set of dumbbells, but if you have different weight ranges, grab those out as well. We're going to be training shoulders, biceps, and triceps. So if you're ready, let's do this. So before we hit the weights, we are going to move our body just a little bit to warm up. So bring those arms up nice and wide, keep them just at shoulder height, not any higher, not any lower, right in line with those shoulders. So keeping chest up and open, we're gonna pivot and twist, reaching for our opposite toe. And as we stand up, every single rep, we wanna squeeze our glutes. So from the side, keep those arms up nice and open, pivot to that opposite side opposite side toe, and squeeze your glutes at the top. Here we're warming up our mobility, bringing those arms, keeping them nice and straight, squeezing the glutes at the top. I'm going here for about 20 reps, okay? So reaching left, reaching right, squeezing at the top, keeping our core engaged. Inhale down, exhale up, and you squeeze the glutes there. If you need to bend your knees a little bit to help you reach towards those toes, you totally can. Listen to your body here for how your mobility, how your stability, core strength, everything is working in your favor, or maybe not so much. So listen to your body is always my big motto, because you know your body best. So let's do 5 more reps here, reaching left side, reaching right side, keeping those arms up and open, nice and straight. Squeezing the glutes at the top. Last 2. Last 1, each toe. So reach opposite toe, opposite hand. Squeeze the glutes at the top, okay? All right, next piece of warm up, we are gonna grab our medium to light weight sets. And what we are gonna be doing is 25 repetitions of some basic movements of the muscle groups we are gonna be working. So we're gonna do a bicep curl, a tricep kickback, and a shoulder press, really just focusing on that muscle-mind connection, making sure that we have the right form before we hit into the circuits, and making sure that we just feel really good in how our body is feeling, how our stance is feeling, making sure it's an appropriate weight for the next sets that we're gonna be doing. And so grab a set of dumbbells. I'm gonna be using a set of 8 pounds, and we'll do about 25 reps of a bicep curl, a tricep kickback, and a shoulder press. Ready? Here we go. First up, bicep curl. So our palms are facing forward, making sure we have that upright posture, shoulders are pulled back, chest is lifted, and elbows are right against our rib cage. So take an inhale to begin, because on the exhale, we're gonna curl up, squeezing on the top, then inhale again in the down phase. So exhale, squeeze up, inhale, coming down. This is 4, 5, squeeze, bring all the way, what did I say, 25 reps? Let's do 25 reps. 7, inhale down, exhale up, squeeze, really focusing on that muscle-mind connection here. We're on the set, 10 reps in. Inhale down, exhale up. Think about squeezing into that bicep muscle there. You've got muscle mind connection. This is 15 coming up. Squeeze at the top. Inhale down. Exhale, squeeze up. Almost at 20. This one right here, 20 reps. Let's go. Final 5. Exhale, squeeze up, inhale, coming down. Your biceps should be burning, warming up that muscle and warming up your muscle line connection. Last 2 reps, squeeze, inhale down. Exhale out. Down to finish, grab a sip of water, and then we go tricep. Next, we're gonna go into a bent over tricep kickback. And so bring those dumbbells just in front of your thighs here. You're gonna think about lifting your chest and shoulders up, and then we're gonna pivot from our hips. So taking that hip hinge as we pivot forward, making sure that our back stays nice and flat. We're not rounding those shoulders or arching our back in any point. We really wanna protect our spine. So think about keeping your core engaged and your trunk stabilized, chest up, shoulders back, and then pivot from those hips in your hip hinge. So to start our bent over tricep kickback, we're gonna come into 1 bent over row, really tuck those elbows in against your rib cage, and then inhale, and exhale, hinge back, squeezing our triceps. We'll go for 25 reps here, making sure that we have that muscle-mind connection. We're keeping a nice neutral gaze, and so we're not looking up with our neck, we're not cranking it down, we're looking straight down with our eye set. We've got 15 more to go, keep squeezing, exhale. Last 10, 9, squeeze, 8, 7, 6, 5, four, three, two, and one. Good job. Grab a sip of water. Take a tiny rest before we hit into those shoulder presses. All right, up next, working into those shoulder taps. And so you're gonna grab your medium lightweight dumbbells, bringing them in over top of your shoulders, lined up. And again, you can really look for your body's alignment here. So you'll see that my wrists are lined up over my elbows. My elbow to my shoulder joint is aligned up. So that is our starting position. Taking a big breath, inhale, and then on the exhale, we're gonna press up, bringing the dumbbells together at the top of the motion. So inhaling down here, exhaling up. Same thing, we're doing 25 reps here, so keeping that spine up straight, core is engaged, so my trunk is braced, I'm not arcing through my back though, but tucking my glutes under instead, helping the core out just a little bit there. This is 10 reps, we've got 15. Inhale, exhale up. Last 10, 9, 8, stay with me, 7, burning, 2, and last one. Good job. Now seriously get a sip of water because we are about to start our circuit. So grab that heavier set of dumbbells or that lighter set of dumbbells if you want to change around the weight ranges of what you're using with these sets. But if you're ready, stay with me because we are about to start our workout. All right, welcome to the circuit. So we have three different movements. We're gonna go through 10 reps on each and then repeat it three times through. And we have three circuits like this, okay? So grab that set of dumbbells that you feel comfortable with. Chest up, shoulders back, core is engaged. Our first one, we are doing one hammer curl going right up into one neutral grip press. So you don't have to do any movement within your wrist. You're keeping your elbows tucked in for that hammer curl and then trying to keep your forearms parallel with each other as you come into that neutral grip press. This is halfway already. 10 reps feels so much easier than 25 for our warm up. Inhaling as we come down here and then exhaling when you come into your curl and into your press. Two more reps to go through. Squeeze biceps, squeeze shoulders. Inhale down and exhale, bring it up. Our next exercise is my favorite to include. We are doing a shoulder side lateral raise. And so bringing the dumbbells just in front of your thighs here, you can think about having chest up, shoulders back, and a slight bend in your elbows. We're gonna take an inhale to begin, and then on the exhale, lift up our dumbbells all the way up to shoulder height. Now what we wanna see here is that you can look that your shoulders, your elbows, and your wrist is all in alignment and all of that is parallel with the ground. So opening up those arms, just bringing them to shoulder height. We don't wanna overextend past them. So keeping the tension right there on the shoulder joint. Last four, three. One more here. Good job, that's it. Next exercise, we do a bicep curl coming into a pivot, coming into a regular stance shoulder press. So your palms are gonna face forward for this one. Chest up, shoulders back, inhale to begin, exhale, curl, pivot, shoulder press, and then inhale the whole way down. Two. This is three, only doing 10 reps here. Inhale down, exhale, curl up, and press. Next one is halfway. Good job, keeping that core tight, thinking about muscle-mind connection just as much as you were when you did those 25 burner warm-up reps. Last three. Last two. Good job, one more rep here. Squeeze biceps, pivot, shoulder press, and return. Good job, take a little sip of water. You are gonna repeat those three movements for 10 repetitions on each and go through those circuits three times, okay? So make sure you follow along the notes in the YouTube description and make sure you actually check it out because I've also included a little freebie workout program just because I'm excited about being on YouTube here. So get ready for the next circuit. I will show you the next three movements. All right, the next three movements are these as follows. So exercise number one, we are doing a single arm alternating front raise. And so chest up, shoulders back, inhale to begin. Exhale, we're gonna cross over our body and keeping the dumbbells here on a 45 degree angle. And so again, just targeting a little bit differently for the angle of the shoulder that we really wanna target on that muscle cap. Doing 10 repetitions here, left arm and right arm each equals out to one, so we're halfway through now. Exhale up, and then inhale on that down phase. Last four, last three, only coming up to shoulders height here. One more rep, cross body and exhale. Exercise number two, you're only gonna need one dumbbell, and so you can place one of those away. And I'm just gonna pause here and adjust my camera height because we are doing a single arm tricep extension. And so let me show you what the full movement is. Okay, just tilting this up a little bit. All right, so one single dumbbell, we're gonna bring it right over top of our shoulder joint here. Now, what we're gonna do is inhale as we bring this arm behind us, trying to keep our elbow and our shoulder fairly lined up. And so squeezing into our tricep here, exhale. You can spot yourself by holding that dumbbell either in place behind your head and just giving yourself a little extra support, or you can hold that arm in if you feel like it's bringing out nice and wide, or not so nice and wide. We really want to keep it tucked in right against our head here. Last three, two, last one. Good, we're gonna repeat that on both arms, so bring it up over top of your shoulder. Inhale, come down, either spotting yourself here or spotting yourself by holding that arm in. Halfway, last five. Three, two, and one. Good job. Grab that second dumbbell because we're gonna need it again. Our third exercise, we are doing a crossbody single arm hammer curl. So chest up, shoulders back, elbows tucked in. Inhale to begin, and then exhale, we're doing a hammer curl. So again, just bringing the dumbbells up vertically. We don't have our palm facing forward, but we are crossing our body. So thinking about drawing a line from your wrist to that opposite shoulder. Exhale up, inhale, come down. Halfway is here. We've got five reps, doing 10 total on each of these exercises. Squeeze. Last three, two, last one. Good job. So those three movements, 10 times on each, three times through that circuit. We are onto our third and final circuit. So we have three exercises here. In the first one, we are going to do a single arm with a front raise, and the opposite arm, we are doing a side lateral raise, and we'll switch arms in between each repetition. So chest up, shoulders back, core is engaged. Inhale to begin. Exhale, one arm is gonna come in front, the opposite arm is coming to the side. Then we are switching, and that equals one rep. So exhale up, inhale down, exhale up, inhale down, that's two. This is three, going all the way to 10. Keeping a slight bend in our elbows. And again, just lifting up to that shoulder height so we can really keep the tension there. We are halfway. Last four. Last three. Two. One. That's it, good job. Next up, we are doing, actually we need both dumbbells still. So next up we are doing a single arm is gonna hold a static isolation hold. Opposite arm, we are doing a bicep curl. So we wanna make sure that that arm that is holding, you're keeping that nice right angle in, so that forearm is parallel with the ground, and you're squeezing, keeping it as an active motion. Last three reps for our bicep curl on that opposite side. Last one is here, then we're gonna hold. Switching sides, exhale up for 10. Good job, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, all the way down. Oh, now you can drop one dumbbell because we just have a single arm motion to finish this last bit of the circuit. We're going to do a rear delt fly, working the backside of our shoulders here. And so keeping that chest up, shoulders back, we're actually gonna pivot from our hips. Keeping a slight bend in our elbow, we'll inhale to start, and then exhale, we're gonna bring that dumbbell up to our shoulder height. So inhale to start, exhale. Keeping a slight bend in our elbow, but otherwise a fairly straight arm. We don't want to be bending our elbows and cranking back, but instead really controlling and isolating the lift from the backside of our shoulders into that rear delt. Let's do five more. Two, last one, before switching over to that opposite side. So chest up, shoulders back, core engaged, hip hinge from your hips to pivot over. Opposite hand, try to just have it hanging down. It can be behind your back or on your hip. If you absolutely need to, you can lightly rest it on that thigh there. So inhale to begin, exhale, bring it up. Today's workout. You are doing those three circuits with three exercises in each for 10 repetitions. Before you hit those circuits though, you want to make sure that you do that high rep of 25 reps for our three warm-up moves. So check the video description below because I've laid out all of the rep ranges and all of the sets that you want to be doing, as well as the names of the exercises. And if you want to learn a little bit more, I've actually linked in a free download for a 7-day Do From Anywhere workout guide. So it's workouts like this where you really just need a set of dumbbells. You can do them at home, or of course you can do them outside or at the gym. But if you like this style of workouts, hit that like button and subscribe, and I will see you next workout.